Welcome to episode 180 of Clarity Compressed. I'm Paul J. Daly, and today we're talking with my friend Dan Moore, who's about to give his TED Talk on Is Your Why a Lie?
Let the good times roll.
This is Clarity Compressed.
So while I was in Napa, I had a chance to catch up with my friend Dan Moore, who released his book, Do More, Get More, and is about to give a TED Talk. He was invited to give a TED Talk in Rosedale about Is Your Why a Lie? So I was able to pull him aside while we were in Napa together and get a little bit of insight on the things that we usually tell ourselves that we're doing things for our family, that we're doing things for beneficial reasons without really fully examining them and asking if that's actually the truth. So I hope you enjoy listening to his breakdown of Is Your Why a Lie? Dan, we are here in beautiful Napa. Thanks for taking time of your busy wine tasting schedule to spend a few minutes with me and the Clarity Compressed audience. Tell me, Is Your Why a Lie? The title of the TED Talk you're about to deliver, what does that mean? Like, where did that come from and why are you talking about that?
Yeah, so super excited. TEDx Roseville. It really kind of came off the book, Do More, Get More. That when you start tapping into your self-awareness, you start realizing some things. So, I mean, for my own personal journey, it was one of those moments of, you know, someone asks you a question of, you know, what's your why or who do you want to be when you grow up? And you start thinking about those things and you give the quick answer. Oh, my family.
And then, right, it's the easy answer.
We're just conditioned response. And then when you kind of walk away, you're like, but is it? And so from there, it was kind of my own personal journey. I'm like, I got to unpack this a little bit. You know, at that time, I was traveling 5-6 days a week, not seeing my family. I'm doing everything for my family. But if I asked my family that question, I'd be like, I'd rather have you home more.
Right. Do they interpret what you're doing as for them?
Yes.
Right? I'm doing it for you. Well, right. It doesn't make me feel good.
Yeah.
Please stop.
Yeah.
Right? Okay. So you're on your own personal journey. Right?
Yep.
You get it. You get invited to do this TED Talk, and now you have to distill this thinking from your book, right? And like TED Talk is no joke. Like you're gonna have it done. What's the length? Is it?
It's 10 minutes.
10 minutes, like hard stop.
You got to punch.
Yep.
So, and that's the beauty of TED, right? I mean, you know this amongst anybody is, it makes you be intentional.
Yep. Right? Does everybody know what TED stands for?
Yeah, that is the fun. I think people need to know. What does it stand for?
You tell me.
How
I don't
say,
think
you
know.
Me.
I didn't think you knew.
I got burned on that one.
Technology, education, design.
Of course he knows that.
Yeah, I don't look at the camera. I'm just kidding. In an interview. I'm just kidding.
I hate him.
You know, Dan is one of my best friends in the auto industry and beyond. Like, if I can't rail him in front of everybody, then it just doesn't count. So
I'm an easy target, bud.
So 10, hard stop, 10 minutes, and... Like when you knew that, like how did you start to distill the message?
I just started working it backwards of first off, you know, you get to the context of like what leaves everybody scratching their head. I mean, when you look at all of the TED Talks that have gone out there, Simon Sinek, everybody, it wasn't about necessarily getting apart an end result. It was getting them to just get the crowd to go, oh. And that's what I took away from looking at just so many great people that have done TED was it's just getting you to stop and think for a second.
Yeah.
So that's where I kind of went. And I was like, okay, so how do I get that punch across?
Okay.
And nice.
Yeah,
and tight.
That makes sense because when you think about stopping and thinking, usually it's because, you know, I talk about the feeling, right? When you can elicit a feeling that causes you to like move, either move or slow down. So what do you think is the biggest, so is your why a lie? I'm an entrepreneur. There are a lot of entrepreneurs watching, a lot of really motivated people, right? If you're not motivated, you're not watching this podcast anyway.
Right.
So it's easy for our personality type to charge.
Correct.
Right? We have deep conviction, deep belief, a lot of energy.
Yep.
Where the traps happen?
Well, the traps, I think, happen with intention. Think about being an entrepreneur, right? We get squirrely.
Yep.
I want to do everything. I want to conquer the world. So we lose intentionality, meaning I have to be focused.
Yep.
What is my primary driver? So I think it's a level of intention. It's also curiosity. I mean, that is the beauty of being an entrepreneur. We're curious by design.
Yep.
So when you start looking at all those different pieces, but then you back up the truce, right? And I use an example, and I'll give you the kind of the awe, if you will, is we all have phones.
We all have what? Phones.
Phones.
Yeah.
It's the greatest utility we have. We can pretty much do anything, anywhere, at any given time. But I relate it back to you is when's the last time you didn't have service or you left your phone at home or you lost your phone? What was that feeling you had?
Terrible feeling, right?
Right.
Feeling. It's almost like a feeling of like lostness, a feeling of like, what am I going to do? How am I going to make it?
Right. But a fear of missing out with your universe that you're connected to. Right?
All day. Oh, my gosh, yeah.
Yeah, so now let me...
Right, there's this whole freight train rolling, and I just got thrown off of it, and it's going.
Right, so now you've connected to that feeling.
Yep.
When's the last time you had that feeling about your wife? When's the last time you had that feeling about your kids?
Oh.
And when's the last time you had that feeling about your life as a whole?
You know, that's really impactful in the sense that usually when you think of once people have that feeling about their wife, it's like too late, unfortunately, or it's like last stop.
Correct.
Right? When you lose a phone, right? Oh, it's iCloud backed up. Even if I can't find it, I know that there's another device close enough that I can catch up. But when it's a family relationship, right? Like, oh, like Cats in the Cradle. All about that. When you have the thought, oh my gosh, that's a paralyzing feeling. Like when you get to that point, it's often too late or just about to be too late.
Right. No, 100%. So, and that's kind of where I'm going. Because at the end of the day, when you kind of get done going through this, you're going to realize a few different things. And it's kind of critical. You've got the curiosity. You've got the self-awareness. But there's the intentionality. And then finally, you putting it in perspective, because we get going so fast. And to your point, hard charging, you miss one key ingredient. We have one ticket to this ride called life. Are you making it count? Are you intentional with it? And what's sacrificing in that moment that you're not paying attention to? Because you're so caught up in the hype of it all, right?
So I know we're kind of going blasting through this because we want to make sure we get all the value. All right, we got like 3 minutes left. I'm an entrepreneur. I'm motivated. I'm connecting with what you say, right? I listen to this. I'm driven. I'm curious. I'm all these things. And I might be thinking like, am I really doing this for the people that I say I'm doing it for?
Right.
And you're starting to question that. How do you get back on track?
And that's the part, right? So you've got to go back through the process. You got to check at the door. Okay. Curious. Am I caught up in the world telling me all the things I can't do? Right.
So tie that into the family for a second, because we don't have a lot of time, but I think the family is probably the place that's going to have the most impact.
Right.
How do you be curious about like your family? Even when you've been married for a while and you have kids that are old, like what's that curiosity?
The curiosity to it is not living vicariously through your kids. It's being curious into what that individual is, each one of them. Like I have three girls, so each one is uniquely different.
Mm-hmm.
And pouring into that and giving them, clearing the runway, if you will, for them to go seek their passion, see what they're fired up about. Then that because then we have something to talk about. They're not living through me. I kind of call it the false idol, if you will. Mm-hmm. Think about all the things that go on, all the hype, you know, people out there. And it's like, you just start, you know, basically regurgitating Gary Vee, for example.
Yeah, right.
Well, you're living somebody else's life. You're not living yours.
Right.
Right. So if we do that with our kids and we remove some of the barriers, the negativities, the you can'ts, and fuel their curiosity and their passion as a parent, now you're starting to connect.
Yeah.
Right. So well, now
everybody,
we're gonna...
yes, everybody likes someone. And this goes even for your kids, but everyone likes an encourager.
Right.
Everyone likes someone that says, oh, you're doing that. Let me help you.
Right.
Or like, let me give you this support. Correct. Let me give you this. And I think as we wrap up, you know, from a relationship standpoint, like say with your wife or your husband, spouse, there's this element of assuming like what we talked about like 15 years ago.
Right.
Like the generality of it is still that, well, we have a family, we have a house,
right,
but it's much more specific than that.
Well, and are you intentional, right? Like how many times are you sitting there with your wife and you're having a conversation and the phone suddenly just kind of came in front of your face?
Mm-hmm.
So wouldn't we say our wife's a lie? I mean, if you're telling me your wife's the most important thing, the phone just took the priority.
Right.
And guilty as charged. I got to realize that, hey, I got to put it down. And in that moment, I've got someone face to face with me and they deserve my attention.
Yeah.
So I have to be intentional.
Is your why a lie? Dan, thank you for just giving us that little quick shot of insight. How can people stay connected with you, find your book, find all the work you're doing, and maybe even connect with your TED Talk?
Yeah, absolutely. So the TED Talk will be on TED.com after it's done. So it's August 7th. And then connecting social media, obviously. Books on Amazon, Do More, Get More. Catchy title.
Do More, Get More. His last name is More. It's
if you don't
thing.
Play on it, I mean, that's branding, right?
It's
branding.
Absolutely. Dan, thank you so much.
Oh, absolutely, man. Great to be on.
Back to the wine tasting.
Oh, yeah, back to the wine tasting. We came to fight.